We now take an extension of the inscribed angle theorem, which is called as a corollary. An extension of the theorem is termed as a corollary. The corollary states that angles inscribed in the same arc are congruent. Okay, so let us take a circle. In this circle, we have two arcs. Remember, the two arcs should have the same endpoint. If two angles are inscribed in the same arc, then they are congruent. Okay, so here we have an angle ABC and we have another angle ADC. Both the angles are inscribed in the same arc ABC. If you can see, they are inscribed in the same arc and they are intersecting the arc AC. So what do we have to prove? That these two angles are congruent. So in given, you'll write angle ABC and angle ADC are inscribed in the arc ABC, or you can also write ADC, whichever you feel convenient. Okay, to prove, what do we have to prove? Angle ABC is congruent to angle ADC. The proof is very simple, students. So we take the proof now. Now if you have a look at this angle ABC, angle ABC is intersecting arc AC. And today we have studied the theorem, angle, inscribed angle theorem, that measure of the inscribed angle is half of the measure of the intercepted arc. So angle ABC is half of measure of arc AC. What is the reason? The reason is by inscribed angle theorem. Fine. Now this is your equation 1. Similarly, go for this angle ADC. Angle ADC is intercepting again arc AC. So again we write, also angle ADC is half of measure of arc AC. This is your equation 2. Reason is the same, by inscribed angle theorem. Okay. Now if you have a look at these two equations, you'll find that the right hand side of the two equations are same. If the right hand side is same, then the left hand side should be same. So here we get, from equations 1 and 2, angle ABC is equal to angle ADC. And this is what you had to prove, that angles inscribed in the same arc are congruent. Okay. We have one more corollary, extension of the inscribed angle theorem. The corollary states that angle inscribed in a semicircle is a right angle. What is the corollary? Angle inscribed in a semicircle is a right angle. Now here we have a circle. Let us take a circle. Now in this circle, we have the diameter AC. AC is the, or AB is the diameter. There is a point here, say C. And if we join this point C with the endpoints A and B, we get a triangle ACB, or we can also call it as an angle ACB. So we have to show that this angle, it is inscribed in this arc ACB. Now, what kind of an arc is this arc ACB? If you have a look, this is the diameter. AB is the diameter. If AB is the diameter, naturally arc ACB and arc AB are semicircles. Okay, so what does the corollary say? Angle inscribed in a semicircle is a right angle. This angle is of 90 degree. This is what we have to prove. So in given, we'll write angle ACB is inscribed in semicircle ACB and it intercepts arc AB. Okay, what do we have to prove? To prove angle ACB is 90 degree. It is a right angle. Right angle means the measure is 90 degree. So in your proof, as AB is the diameter, therefore arc ACB will be equal to arc AB will be equal to 180 degree. Okay, or you can write measure of arc ACB is equal to measure of arc AB is equal to 180, since both are semicircles and measure of a semicircle is 180. Okay, now angle ACB is equal to half of measure of arc, which arc? AB. Fine. Now what is angle ACB? Angle ACB is half of measure of arc AB. Measure of arc AB is how much? 180. So angle ACB is equal to 90. This is what you have to prove, that angle inscribed in a semicircle is a right angle.